Yo, what's up, folks? It's Smith. If you're new here, we're going to be checking out a new game by Jam City, and it's called World War Dough. And that's dough as in Play-Doh. But we'll get more into that in a second. I want to send a quick shout-out to my subscribers out there and let you guys know that this is not a city-building game like we normally play here on this channel. World War Dough is a real-time strategy mobile game that combines collectible card games, tower defense, and multiplayer online battle arena. Jam City was so gracious and granted me early access to this game, so I just wanted to get in, throw out some strategy for you guys, and let you guys know what I think of the game. Alright, now first off, it is a portrait mode game. Portrait mode, which means it's oriented like that. So that's unique for most mobile games, not exactly for RTSs. Most RTSs are portrait-oriented games. Now, your main objective is to get more stars than your opponent. Now, tell us how to get the stars, Smith. Okay. There are two towers. Well, technically, there's four towers. Because you have two and your opponent has two. But anyway, each tower is worth one star. And if you eliminate your opponent's commander, then you automatically get three stars. So, you want to try to go for the three-star action. Go ahead and eliminate their commander, but if you can't quite get there, just take out one or two towers, one more than they do, and you'll win the game. Now, let's talk about the commander. One thing that's unique about this game is you have 100% control over your commander's movement. That's something that comes in handy when you're trying to evade the enemy or when you're leading the charge. Now, about the dough, like I said, it looks kind of like Play-Doh. But it's at the bottom of your screen, and it's the elixir-like stuff that's filling up your bar. Each second or so, you get a deposit, and it fills up. Now, you have to spend this dough to place a card into battle. You notice on your cards, there's a number with the little dough icon. That indicates how much dough you will have to use in order to put this card onto the screen. Your commander does not use dough. A few seconds into the game, you and your opponent will each get a drop from the sky, a barrel of elixir, all for the taking. Now, you need to tap the barrel in order to send your commander to collect it. And you can steal your opponent's dough. And in turn, he can steal yours. So, that's something that is cool and can be a curse if you let your opponent steal your dough. Then you're out of dough. Alright, now, one other thing that's unique about World War Dough is that your towers not only defend, but they also have functions that augment your commander's ability. The tower on your left is your heal tower, so when you're low on health, and if your commander is running around the map like mine is here, bleeding profusely, missing an arm, then you tap that at the specific time, a designated time, and you will get a boost in your health. Now, the tower on the right is your rage tower, and its rage function gives your commander a damage boost that lasts about 10 or 15 seconds. Now, each tower has a cooldown period as well, so it's about 40 seconds, maybe 30, 40 seconds, so be strategic in how you use them. Now, like I said earlier, the number one objective, remember, is to protect your commander at all costs. And you also have to protect your towers. So here to help you accomplish that are your cards. Now with this game, you have a normal deck of cards, your troops, your building cards, your spell cards. So let's start with the troops. You have a wide range of melee troops, ranged troops, ranged troops, and air units. Now each one of them are unique. I've already unlocked about 40 cards. Now, as far as the buildings go, the building cards, you have defense buildings like cannons and siege weapons, air defense, spawners, all types of building cards. And then you also have now your spell cards. Now, there's spells that do direct damage to other troops on the map. There's some that absorb damage, like this dome here, the safety dome. And some spells even infect your enemies, or in turn, you can get infected. When they explode, they spawn these alien-like bugs that are part of the infection. Now, let's check out some of the features that the game has to offer. You've got your store over here, where you can purchase in-game currency, They also have a VIP program and rewards for watching ads. So if you're into that, it's a quick way to get up in the ranks in the game, watch a few ads, join the VIP programs, get some cards in the daily deals, and you're all good. Now, there's a lot more resources to check out that can be purchased with real money. All right, let's move on to the prep shop. That's where you can prepare your decks. Now, you have 5 slots that you can use. And also, under the Commander and Emotes tab, you can buy skins and do cool dances to show off to your opponents. Look at this one I just bought, the Dougie. The guy's doing the Dougie. So, I'm going to use that emote to taunt my enemy the next chance I get. In the Battle tab, you have 4 slots for your chests. There's a lot of different chests that you can get. Most of them take about 4 to 6 hours. Some take 8 hours to unlock. Some even take 24 hours, up to 2 days. I've unlocked one that took up to 2 days. Your progression ladder is where you can receive rewards as you achieve more trophies in the game. Then you also have your social tab where you can chat with friends, request cards, or join to create a club. Lastly, you can find events that are coming at a later date, and so on and so on. So all in all, I'd say play this game for about a week and you'll be hooked just like I am. Get used to the gameplay, and trust me, once you start progressing in the game, you'll want to get better and better. I personally like the graphics. It's not jaggedy. It's bright and the animation is smooth. The sound effects and explosions are exciting, and the matches are not too long. If you 3-star your opponent, you can do that at any time, but most matches last about 3 minutes. So I've already got 5 decks that I'm excited to show you guys in upcoming videos, so smash that like button, pound the subscribe button, and I'll see you next time. Peace out.